In this demonstration, I'm going to show how you can use a 2D map mesh to essentially be the seed for a 3D mesh. Now, map meshes allow you to better control the distribution of elements across a surface rather than a free mesh. And some examples for this might include fillets or cylinders. And then we'll also get into how to use a mesh mating condition. So mesh mating conditions are used to connect individual 2D or 3D meshes together at a specified interface. In this example, we have three cylindrical bodies, and we'll start off by creating a map mesh on the outer face. So here we'll select this face and give it a value, we'll say 20. And we've created our 2D map mesh for that cylindrical face, and we'll do the same for the adjacent face. We'll give it some variation. So here we have our interface. You can see there's clear variation between element sizes and how the elements are not congruent. So let's apply a 3D sweat mesh to our bodies. Now, if we zoom in a little bit, we can see that by using the 2D map mesh, we can change the distribution of elements for our 3D mesh. So let's get into an example of that. We'll get into our map mesh. Say we want to increase the size. And we'll update our model, and our 3D mesh will be updated accordingly based on the distribution of our 2D mesh. Now let's change that back to 10. We'll update. Now we're back to our original mesh that we created. Let's also create a 3D mesh for our rod. And we'll just keep the default element size. Now let's do a cross-section view and see what's going on at the interfaces. If we zoom in, we can again see that the elements are not congruent. We have a variation in size. So at this point, we have completely separate meshes. And we can see that at our rod and hollow cylinder as well. So there's even a gap between the two. So how can we change that? So there's different methods we can use to connect these meshes together. We can go back to the CAD and unite the bodies together so it's one body. Sometimes that's not really feasible or wanted. Or we can go into the sim and create glue or contact connections, which again, that creates a little bit more workload. We can use what's called mesh mating conditions. And this will create a connection between all the meshes. So if we select all the individual bodies, it will create two glue coincident MMCs. So I'll create a MMC along this interface and along this interface. Now let's go ahead and update our model. And now what we see is a congruent mesh between all bodies. So they're all still separate meshes, but they're connected together. So here we can see the variation in element sizes. And we can also see that inner rod and hollow cylinder connection is again, has a congruent mesh and is connected together.